Hey everyone, it's me Suchita. Welcome back to my channel and I hope you all are doing absolutely fine. Today in this video, I'm going to talk about some middle school maths activities. Yes, on your demand, I'm here with some very interesting and interactive maths activity which you can do in a group as well as consider as an individual activities. So let's start today's video. If you are new to the channel, do consider subscribing, press the bell icon and give me a thumbs up, give me a like to support and to motivate as like I'm doing for you. So let's start. First activity is a toothpick and marshmallow activity to teach geometrical shapes and to tell to explain the different angles, basically to deal with the geometrical 3D shapes. You can use this activity. What you need to do, you take the marshmallows and the toothpick as showing in the picture, that you just connect the toothpick with the marshmallow, and it's very easy and handy also. It will not take any screw and any glue required to make the shape, and you can use the same toothpicks again and again to show the different shapes and different angles like that. It's an amazing activity. At the end, you can say the marshmallows which the students are using, they can eat them, or maybe they will get 2 marshmallow, 3 marshmallow if somebody is able to make a good shape. So it will be interesting activities and students will be very much excited that today the marshmallows which they crave to eat, they are going to use in the activity. Another way to teach the geometrical shape, we can include as a project work or you can say a group work. For that, you can ask them to design a geometrical city. As you can see in this picture, by using the different shapes and by using mentioning the different shape, you can give them a target that by using the 10 geometrical shape, they need to design this area. Or you can say by using 3 geometrical shape, they need to design the kitchen. By using the 4 geometrical shape, maybe they need to design the building. By using 5 geometrical shape, they need to design this hospital. Like that, you can design as a geometrical city as a project. This is a wonderful project, and 2 or 3 students, maybe individual student, can do it as a homework, or you can implement in the class as well. Second activity is a door marking activity. See, as a child, when I was learning my maths in my middle school, I was really confused with the angles, especially with the 60 and 120 degree. I always look at the scale where to mark 60, where to mark 120. So we need to use some basic life skills, or you can say we need to relate the concepts with the real life examples so that it will bring a clarity in thoughts of the children. So what you can do, and this is the activity you can include in your demo presentation or also at the time of your recruitment, because for that you need to just carry the sticky notes which is easily available at any stationery shop. Use the sticky notes of different colors as you can see in the picture, and for the lines, if you are giving the class presentation, you can use, because it takes time to put the line. Other than that, if you are going for a demo, just use the sticky notes, that also fine. Now when the child is going to close the door, when he'll start, he open the door, he can see the different angles. So in same way, you can show the angles of the half side, and then you can explain if the door can't move. Okay, this side is coming 60 degree here, if the door is able to move further 120 degree and then lead to the 180 degree, in that way you able to mark the angles and you able to explain them with a very interesting and interactive activity. You can ask a group of 4 students to come and mark with the sticky notes, and then one student will open the door. So in that way, you are involving a physical movement in the class with discipline plus a lot of interaction from the student side. Third activity is a equation intercept and graph puzzle activity. What you need to do, you need to select the 4 equations and the 4 children. I make them sit in a group and you give them 4 questions with different shape. For example, this question I cut in a different shape. This question you cut in a different shape, and this question you cut in a different shape. Now they need to solve the equation, they need to find out the intercept and try to plot the graph, and then they will make a puzzle. Each student has to complete 1 equation. So they will try to make a puzzle, and they will discuss with the student, oh no, you are using my part, this will go with this setup. So in that way, you are including game plus a very important topic of their middle school basic math. Activity number 4 is to explain the fractions. you know, even now as a teacher, I struggle sometimes to explain 1/4 part, 1/3 part, to half part. Like, you know, it's very difficult to make them familiarize with the fraction. So for that, what you do, you need a disposable plate, which I think easily available at your home. Ask the student to color it, and then we will divide into 4 parts. Like that, we can mention it's 1/4, and you use the sticky notes to showing the parts 1/4, 1/4. Maybe in the same plate, you ask them to design 1/2, but just by just changing the sticky notes. In that way, you are able to implement the stream. Stream is basically the integration of one subject with the other subject. So here you are including the drawing, the arts, in the maths. So I think this is a very interesting way to teach fractions, and they'll enjoy that concept, that when the student will drawing and they are coloring, that concept is going deep into their mind. Activity number 5, this is a lock and key puzzle. Yes, for this activity you can use for a simple addition, subtraction, multiplication or division. Or maybe as a maths teacher, you know better than me, for simple which questions we can include this. So what you need to do, I know this will take time, you just need to print the lock and key with the help of printer on a page and then cut them in the shapes. So you need to just cut out the key like this, and they have to check which lock question will go with the answer of that particular key. So in this way, instead of using the traditional pen and paper method, you are using a 3D and creative method to solve such questions. Activity number 6, and this is a foil technique. F-O-I-L, foil technique. Yes, in this activity, that board mass formula where the student will struggle which to multiply with what. So in that way, you can just prepare a flashcard with the 3D words like foil, and you just paste it near to your blackboard or near your smart board, and just ask every time when you will face the same question, just ask the students to use the foil technique, and they know that foil means first outer, inner later. So when you're saying foil, they understand this thing, that you are asking them to use the technique to solve the question. Activity number 7, this is a butterfly activity. Yes, by using this activity, we can solve the cross multiplication question. Cross multiplication is a very tricky technique. We as a teacher feel very easy, but for some students nowadays, it's very difficult to make them understand how they are cross multiplying the numbers. So what you can do, instead of just writing the cross multiplication, try to draw a butterfly, and the students are very creative. They are very into with the shapes. So once you include the idea of butterfly with a beautiful design, so that thing will go deep in their mind. They'll able to relate the method with a butterfly picture. You know, maths is a topic where most of the students feel boring, sleepy. They feel like less interested in that subject. So by including all these things, the butterfly thing, you are not making the things easy, but you are attracting their attention. You are making them, or you can say you force them to look towards you, to give attention to your questions. And this is a big achievement as a math teacher, what I feel. Activity number 8. This is a glass rolling activity. Yes, for that you need to use the disposable glass papers. And like this, what you need to do, you need to write the different combination of questions there. So you'll ask your student to match the different combination and color them with the same color. For example, this combination, green, then ask them to move again, and then they are again finding one another combination, they'll color it with a red color. So every question and the combination got the same colors at the end. So they keep on moving and they're solving the question in the notebook, and they are trying to match the same at the disposable glass. Activity number 9 is a candy bag activity. See, this is an open activity you can use for any question. Maybe you are showing them combination, maybe you are asking them for skip counting, maybe you are showing them the tables, which numbers are coming in the table of 5, which number are coming in the table of 10. So the number which are coming in the table of 5, they need to put in this candy bag, and the number which are coming for the in the table of 10, they need to put in this candy bag. In that way, you are able to collect the same candies in the same bag. These all activities are very useful activities, interactive activities I can say, and you know, you keep this stuff ready and you can reuse them again and again in many time for different activity. Maybe the glass rolling activity first you use for addition, then subtraction, then division. So the same activities you can use in different questions. The graph and equation activity, the puzzle you can use for any other graph activity or any other kind of equation activities. So it's up to you. I am just giving you a hint how, which kind of shapes, which kind of things you can include in the math activity, and you, it's your way. I think you are much far better creative than me, and you will include the same activity for any of your topic. So that's all for today's video. I hope you like the video, and if you like the video for whatsoever reason, give me a thumbs up and write down in the comments what you are feeling about the video. I hope you are growing well in your career, staying healthy at home. Thank you. Bye bye.